don't push it against the wood. You know, just start the blade.
I do something silly like that, you laugh hysterically.
Hoggard na naman ako, guys. Ang dami naming lakad today. From dalawang Costco store. We're here at Lowe's. Gusto niyang palitan lahat ng sa bed namin. Yung everything. So comfort. Grabe. Is that what you need, sweetheart? Ang ganda ng mga parang pinto-pinto. Ayan. Parang pwede ka nang bumili sana ng mga finished na. Sweetheart! Sweetheart! You look macho. You look macho, sweetheart. Okay, it's tired na guys, hindi na namamansin. It's a really tiring day. Dami namin ginawa. To use this one, guys, it's a saw. Ano na siya? Sobrang dali lang niya gamitin. Ayan, o, diba? May measurement na tapos may light pag guys. Ganun, guys. So, I don't want to use without Charles. I'm scared.
Right here.
That light is the left hand side of the light.
Mm-hmm.
So all the cut is going to be on the right-hand side of that light.
Okay.
So it would have to be 16 to 8 inches that time to get finished. So it's like 72 inches now. Okay. So I can cut off 69, that's going to be 4 inches, and I still have plenty to cut off the other end. But a lot of times the factory gave is rough. So I'll cut. The other one I didn't cut on both ends because I didn't realize that when I looked at the load, I didn't realize that it had splits on the end of it. So I could just cut all of them. Alright, so you want the wood up against the guide. So you hold the wood with one hand, with your left hand.
Okay.
You take your right hand. You move it down so you get it close because you don't want the blade running any higher than it has to be.
Okay.
Because it's a safety hazard. So you get it down pretty close to where you want it, and then you pull this trigger, and then you just, after the blade starts, then you just run it down till it cuts.
Where are you going to turn that on? It will automatically on? Oh, okay.
No, there's the trigger. I told you.
Okay.
Right there.
Yeah.
So you do it.
Oh.
In the wood.
Okay.
So you definitely want to get rid of this.
Okay. All yeah. Right? Yes.
You want to, there's a little tiny one down here that it'd be nice to go ahead and get rid of it too.
Mm-hmm.
So you can measure and you can say, okay, I need to cut off about an inch on that side.
Okay.
Can I get rid of this knot here too?
Mm-hmm.
So the wood needs to be 60 and 3/15.
Okay.
So if I'm going to cut off an inch down at the other end, I add another inch, and I say, okay, can I get to 61 and 3/16 and still cut off this knot? Yep, I can.
There's a lot of knots right here as well.
But I can't do anything about those. Those are going to be way too far back for me to cut. I've only got about 12 inches that I can cut off.
Okay.
So what I'll do is, just to make sure something doesn't screw up on the other end, I'm going to bring this one back. I know I've got, I've got 3 or 4 inches at least to play with.
How can you have the light, sweetheart? You press it?
Yes, you press it.
Oh. Okay.
This one, all I'm trying to do is basically cut off this knot.
Okay.
So you can cut it.
I'm going to press this side. Once already.
You're going to put your hand here, and you're going to make sure it's pushed up against there, and then you keep your hand away from the blade.
Okay. I'm going to open my hand.
No.
Oh.
You're going to do it
all
now. Okay. So you pull it down a little bit to get it closer to the wood, so you don't want the blade running any higher than you have to, because you want to start it when the blade is close to the wood because it's a safety issue. All right, now that's good.
I can figure it out now?
Yes. Don't push it against the wood. Okay, now we'll start the blade. Trying to cut a precise cut, you would have messed up because you jerk the sawdown.
It just make it smooth.
Yeah.
Let me try again the last one.
Look, also,
it's like, it's not smooth there.
Well, I've got.
Is this fine?
No, I've got
sandpaper
there.
Oh, okay.
It's smooth.
It's really like that? It always happened like that?
Yeah.
No. I will do it again. It's like it's a small cut.
So you get it, you have to get it perfect.
We have a lot of M6
seconds. So I want to have 60 and 3/16 left.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to come over here. I'm going to hold them tight so it's tight up against there. I'm going to look for 64. 63, 60 and 3/16. That's One, two, three, 16ths.
It should be 60.3.
60 and 3/16. And the oldest others.
This one, you have to make sure that you have the right measurement, right?
60. Mm-hmm. There's 60.
Okay.
1, 2, 3. Mm-hmm. 3/16.
Okay, so 60, and then you count 1. It's about 60.5.
No. Each one of these small marks is a 16th of an inch. So, 2/16 is what?
Mm-hmm.
It's an eighth.
Okay.
3/16, 4/16. 4/16 is what?
4.
4/16 in fractions is what? The lowest common denominator of 4/16 is what?
4.
No.
What?
4/16 equals what? And the lowest common denominator.
2/8. I don't know fraction. I forgot.
Right there, turn it on. Turn it on.
Huh?
I had it lined up for you, right? That's you're fortunate. But,
mm-hmm.
But what you need to do is you need to have you need to look at it. So if your mark is right here,
mm-hmm.
you want to make sure. Check it again. You check again that last time before you cut to make sure the wood hasn't moved.
Yeah.
But a lot of times it does. Mm-hmm. The wood will shift on you.
There's another one. There's another
two.
Two.
And you take the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Because we didn't have a box spring too high.
Normally I would measure it, but I'm really tired, so These are the screws I like. I'm sorry, I got this mixed up.
Yeah, it's a Sabre drive.
Yeah. I got it mixed up.